What is good, guys? We're here with Poik versus Flame Victini. This is pretty much a rematch. They played for a Smogon Championship like just 1 or 2 weeks ago. Let me look at the teams real quick. So I would assume that Specs or Z-Move Gengar on FE side. Let me see. Yeah, I would think Mega Gyarados and Scarf Kartana probably. It has to be AV Megina in my opinion. He's way too weak to stuff like Greninja. I mean, yeah, if he's Mega Gyarados, he can check Ashgrin. But before he's Mega, he still cannot switch into Greninja at all. And AV Megina just makes sense to check Lily. Like, Kartana, obviously, does have Piss Poor Spadev and cannot check stuff like Lily or anything. So, like, Megina just makes sense with AV. On Poik's side, Mega Scizor team, probably with a Bantar. I would assume that this is a Scarf Lando on Poik's side. And on Effie's side, this is probably Rock's defensive Lando. Yeah, that's my guess. And I would assume Poik is just gonna go into his Scizor here. And then potentially defog the Rocks the way that Flame Victini is gonna set up. And yeah, Z-Move uses on Poik's side, I would assume either the Greninja or the Heatran is Z-Move. And the Ferrothorn is probably more Spadev orientated. This is I would guess Fizdev Scizor. So he can afford to run offensive Lando when he has a defensive Scizor. Exactly, he can afford to run Scarf Lando. U-turns out, and just as I thought, Poik has a probably Scarf Lando, and Effie has a defensive Lando as he shows to have Rocky Helmet. Nice play going into Greninja, covers the rocks and the HP ice. And even if he U-turned, he was intimidated there. And now I assume Poik, if he has spikes, he can go for that. Effie is probably gonna go into the Megina here. I could also see Effie making a risky play and staying in, but he just plays it safe. Poik gets up the spike, and he is Battlebond Greninja. Now, I could see Effie going for HP Fire, because it catches the Ferrothorn. Or, actually, it would not cover the Heatran play. Actually, if he has a double that covers all these three mons, then he should double. Let me see. I think maybe double into Kartana would be a good play, because it covers the Ferrothorn, it covers the Heatran, and it covers the Landorus, kind of. Yeah, I think double into Kartana is a good play, because if you Volt Switch, obviously that covers the Ferrothorn to Heatran, but it doesn't cover the Landorus. So you want to make like a double that covers all options. Poik is obviously not going to stay in here with the Greninja. I have recorded a few games today, but I haven't uploaded any other games, because I don't feel that good. I have only slept a few hours. And I might have to re-narrate some of the games in the next day. So yeah, just stay tuned for that. That's going to be coming. Just be a bit patient. Yeah, like, double into Katana, I think he is a pretty nice play. As it covers, like I said, exactly. The Pharaoh, the he didn't go make the play, though. He went into Lando. That covered the Heatran, and it's still a fine play. It's still a fine play, but I think Katana would have been a bit better. Now, Poik is getting up spikes and rocks. Effie is probably Scarf defog on Kartana. Is he Leech Sheets here? T-Waves. He T-Waves predicting a switch out into potentially Kartana or into anything else, into potential HP Fire Megina. Now I assume Poik is just gonna either Leech Seed or maybe switch into Scizor. Leech Seed? Yeah, he misses. That's annoying for him. Because his Ferrothorn being low sucks. Ferrothorn would have been nice to check the Gyarados. It's nice for if the Megina doesn't have HP Fire, it can check that as well. And it can potentially also take a hit from the Zygarde, depending on the Zygarde set. But it's not so good versus the Zygarde, it's more so for the Gyarados. Now, I think Effie is gonna U-turn here, actually. He doesn't. Okay, he off-quicks again. I thought that Poik's switch out there was a bit obvious, but he didn't switch. He just Leech Sheets. Now, this is T-Wave Leech Sheet Spikes. The last move probably is Power Whip, I would guess. So it's only one attacking move. T-Wave makes sense because his team is somewhat slow. I mean, he does have double priority and a Scarf. I mean, yeah, it's not that slow. But yeah, T-Wave is probably to catch incoming Kartana. To catch incoming Heatrans and cripple them, because Heatran can definitely be a threat to this team. Greninja can only switch him one time, and Tyranitar doesn't check heat turn as well as some people might think, especially some heat turns run Corkscrew Crash. I know it's not common, but it's definitely an option. So now Poik is going to Mega Evolve and Roost because he definitely wants the Scizor healthy for the Zygarde. And I think Flame Victini should just U-turn out here. U-turn is obviously a fine play. Now, if the Scizor for some reason attacks with Bullet Punch, it will take helmet damage. But yeah, Roost is the only play here. And yeah, U-turn is completely fine. Probably U-turn into... He actually doesn't have much for the Scizor. This is actually interesting. If he's Ghost Gym, he can U-turn into his Gengar. Or he could U-turn into his Meginna if he has HP Fire. But the problem is, if his Meginna gets worn down, he might just lose the game to Battlebond Greninja. Obviously, we will talk about the score of the series after the game. I think Poik goes on the Cryos, and FV is on the... I forgot. So he's just going to U-turn and Scizor is going to Roost. Yeah, maybe HP Fire Meginna is going to come out, or Gengar is my guess. Well, I guess Gyarados. Gyarados is also a chance. There's a chance Gyarados might come out as well. Because, like I said, he doesn't want the Meginna to get worn down for the Greninja. Yeah, Gyarados would make some sense. I mean, the Lando is at 70, which means after Rocks, I think it can barely take a... It might be able to take a Bandit Stone Edge from T-Tar. I'm not actually sure if it can take one. It kind of depends on how much speed he runs on his Lando. If he runs a lot of speed, that would mean he loses bulk, obviously. I'm just trying to think, when Poik's Banitar comes in later in the game, it's pretty threatening. Because Banitar tend to carry Fire Punch, so Kartana doesn't want to switch in either. Also, this Scizor might not have HPI, might not have U-turn, it might have HPIs. HPIs, Bullet Punch, Roost, and Defog. It might also not have Defog, but and have U-turn, but HPIs is definitely an option. Because this team is somewhat weak to Zygarde, right? For sure, yeah. Because it's offensive Lando, and Pharaoh is probably more Spadef orientated. So yeah, he does go into Meginna, which is what I thought at first, confirming that he most likely has HP Fire. Otherwise, he's just bluffing it. So Poik is probably gonna go into Heatran here, or Landorus. Landorus would be trying to block a Volt Switch and also covers the HP Fire play. And Heatran obviously covers Volt and HP Fire, but it doesn't cover Volt in the sense that Effie would get momentum. So I think... Huh, does he need health on Lando? I mean, health on Lando is nice to have, because then he can keep coming in on rocks. So he does go Heatran here, anticipating the HP Fire. And Effie just goes for HP Fire. I really thought he would have either gone for Volt Switch or for Flare Cannon. Volt Switch would have been if he predicted the Heatran. Flare Cannon would have been if he predicted the Landorus. Because I really think Poik needs the Scizor healthy at all costs for the Zygarde. So I did not think Poik would have ever stayed in there. So I'm a bit surprised that Effie went for HP Fire there. Now, he does not have a switch into... if this is Magma Storm. Oh, it could be Z-Move because he doesn't have leftovers. If this is Inferno Overdrive, something's dying here. I mean, Zygarde might live it, but like with Hazards up, it will take like a fuck ton. So this is... I would assume either Z Magma Storm or Z Earth Power. He doesn't have the Tapu Bulu. If he had a Bulu, I would assume that it could be Z Bloom Doom, but that's what Poik used versus FV the last time they played each other. He had Z Bloom Doom, but this time I assumed Z Magma or Z Earth Power. More so, I think it's Z Magma, probably. I mean, his team is... Like, Poik's team is quite annoyed by Toxapex, so Z Earth Power also would make sense, but it doesn't have to be, because a Magma Storm with Taunt and Earth Power beats Pex anyway. But Groundium just beats it a bit better, because then you don't have to take as many Scalds. Also, Poik's team is, it's super annoyed by Pex, because Tita doesn't want to switch in on Pex, because it can get burned. Scizor gets walled by Lando if it doesn't want to get burned, and Greninja and Pharaoh also kind of lose to it. So this would make sense if it's... it obviously has to be Magma Trapper Tran for the packs. So Gyarados is gonna go down, I assume, to the... Oh my god! I thought it was the Magma Storm. It makes sense, because I just talked about it. He's relatively weak to packs. But I think he should have gone for Magma Storm there. The reason why he went for that is I think he anticipated the Zygarde to come out. I think he anticipated the Zygarde. And the Zygarde obviously would have been able to take a Magma Storm. And I assume he also didn't want to risk missing. Magma Storm. But I think Flash Fire boosted Magma Storm would have been a good play there. Now the Gyarados, if it has Crunch or Earthquake, it should be able to kill the Ferrothorn from this range. Especially if it's a Morspeed Death Ferro. But yeah, I'm pretty sure he's going to be able to kill this. Now, does he want a Mega? He probably doesn't... Let me see. He doesn't want a Mega because if he Megas, the Landorus U-turn becomes super effective. And Scizor's U-turn also becomes super effective. So it is Z-Morph, so if he catches me off guard there, did not see that one coming. So the Gengar is probably Specs then. I thought this was Mega Gyarados. Wow, he got me. So he does not have a Mega. Yeah, wow. Crazy. It is... Oh, it's Moxie, so it's plus 2 now. And this is actually hard for Poik to revenge. Poik has to go Lander here if he Scarf? Or he goes Scizor? I mean, Scizor doesn't have a move to hit this, right? It only has Bullet Punch and U-turn, right? That is so way too much. So Poik... Oh, he has Knock Off, okay. Yeah, but Poik can't win this now. I thought he would have... If he had Stone Edge, he could have gone to Landris. But maybe he doesn't have it. His team is relatively weak to Pinsir, so I thought he would have Scarf Stone Edge or Scarf Rock Slide. Or maybe he wants to get it in range from Scarf Lando, because Scarf Lando obviously does outspeed Gyarados. But now he's also super weak to Zygarde that he lost to Scizor, so I think this game is over. I think Effie has this game. And this turn around, I thought it was looking better for Poik at first. Obviously, one of the least sheep miss with the Ferrothorn on the Landorus sucked. Was there anything else, Hexy? He only has U-turn, he doesn't have Stone Edge, probably. Which is why he went Scizor first, and he still couldn't bring it in range. So this was Knockoff Scizor, which makes me think it was an SD Knockoff Bullet Punch and Roost Scizor. Which is super weird to me, because... I mean, it makes sense, because Knockoff can get rid of the band on Zygarde. He gets up the scent, so Gyarados goes down to the scent the next turn. Now he can get his Ash potentially, so Effie exactly wants to switch out so he does not get the Ash form. Is he Water Shuriken? Yeah, Water Shuriken. He was forced to Shuriken there because he doesn't want to lose his Greninja, obviously. I mean, he would have maybe been able to live a Waterfall, but he doesn't want to take any damage on his Greninja. Obviously, Bounce would not have worked there because if he Bounce, he would die to Sandstorm. He's just going to Heat Turn here on the Volt Switch. Volt Switch was a bit risky because it didn't cover the Landorus, but... Yeah, I think it was fine because Poik wasn't going to risk the Landorus that turn. Yeah, I think the... Oh yeah, what I was talking about Scizor versus Zygarde. If it has Knock Off, it can get rid of Choice Band, so in that sense it's good versus Zygarde. But if the Zygarde is like a coil setup variant, then it could actually be bad that the Scizor doesn't have HP Eyes. So I'm a bit surprised by that. I think his team is relatively weak to Zygarde. He even has HP. I'm saying. His team is weak to Zygarde. But then the second I said that, he pulls up with the tech. HP, IV, ground, the off part turn. Okay. So that's some nice damage. But a Graph Berry healing so much back. So this is probably DD Coil, Thousand Arrows and E-Speed, right? And yeah, Lando can take that with Intimidate, so this might be bulky Scarf Lando. Not 100% sure on that. Might also be, yeah, HP Eyes is gonna whip to it KO, but Lando obviously goes down here. And now Greninja can come out, and I think it can live with E-Speed because it's not banded, and it's obviously at neutral. So he sacks the Gyarados to Rocks, which is a smart play because he doesn't want to give him the Battle Bond. And now he can come out with his Scarf Katana here. Click Sacred Sword twice and win the game. Pretty sure Katana wins the game if it's Choice Scarf. So this was a cool game. What was I trying to say? Like today, yeah. Basically, I uploaded like 6 or 7 games yesterday. Like I think 6 games. So if you guys missed any, go check them out. The playlist is linked at the end of the video. If I don't forget it, I will also put it in the description. Because I think sometimes not every video goes through to the sub box. But today I just... did not have the motivation to record much. I didn't sleep much and I recorded so many games the other day. So you guys can expect... you can check out the games that you missed if you haven't watched them yet. Or you can just wait a bit, because the other games that happened today, I recorded them. I just have to narrate over them, over most of them. Also, obviously, the lower tiers, my man Ultra Balls is helping me out with that. So yeah, Katana comes out here. Greninja, if it can kill the Katana, needs a lot of hits, and I don't think it can because it's not in Ash form yet. I know in Ash form it would probably die the Katana, but it's not the case. So, like, regular Greninja only has 103 base special attack, and Ash has like 153, so there's a huge difference for sure. So he does have to go. He does get a crit. So if he can get like 5 hits, maybe he can kill him if he gets 5 hits. And he gets 5 hits with a crit. Ooh. Like, see, this was so in Effie's favor. Like, he, oh my god, he needed 5 hits. And it might have been a roll without a crit, even. Wait, I don't even know. It might not have been a roll. It might have lived without a crit. 22 means without a crit, it would have done. Crit is 1.5, right? So, 18, 16. Oh god, my math is super off at the moment. Let me see. Yeah, that had to be. I think that had to be like a roll or something. I just can't think clearly at the moment. Now, Magina should be able to live a water shuriken, but now if Poi can actually win this game, that's crazy. Wait. Doesn't he just win now with Hydro Pump spam? Depends on if he's in it depends on if he's in E speed range from Zygarde after rocks. If he's not in E speed range from Zygarde after rocks, he can switch out in Heatran here, come back in, and then click Hydro Pump 4 times. And obviously he has to connect 4 Hydro Pumps, which is not easy to do. But if he can connect 4 Hydro Pumps, he can win. Let me calc real quick. Then that was a crazy turnaround. This game was so over in my mind. obviously he's just gonna off power here, because so does he ensures that the Ginga doesn't get a substitute up. Actually, no. Can he win with Dark? He can win with Dark Pulse. He doesn't have to hit Hydro Pump, yeah. He can just win with Dark Pulse. Yeah, he just wins with Dark Pulse, I think, because Magina after Hazards. Actually, Magina might not be in range. I would have to. How much does Magina take from Greninja? Obviously, Gengar obviously dies to Dark Pulse, but how much does Magina take? 13 to 16%. And it is at. It is at 20 plus Spike. Okay, so Dark Pulse might be a roll, but I think Magina can still live a Dark Pulse. Yeah, Magina can still live a Dark Pulse, most likely. Depending on how Shodan rounds up or down here, it might be a roll. So the thing is, do you risk hitting 4 Hydro Pumps? And also have to calc if E-Speed from Zygarde would kill. E-Speed from Zygarde doesn't kill, this is 37 to 44. This is not Max Attack Zygarde, but it's Adamant. Let me make Max Attack just to make sure that Greninja can live. Greninja lives the E-Speed. So he goes for Dark Pulse. So this is a roll, I think. Oh, he gets the Cursed Body. Oh my god. I mean, he did get the 5 Shuriken and the crit, so. That was Hex for Hex. But also the. Obviously now Flame Vitini just wins. Shout out to Cursed Body Gengar. Also, he did miss Lishi with his Ferrothorn, which sucked, because then he would have been able to. I know he would not have been able to live a move from Gyarados, because the Gyarados was Sky Strike. Like, I don't think that Lishi miss had like a huge impact, but it was obviously annoying. So that was a crazy end game. At first I thought Poik was in a fine position, then he reveals to be not Mega Gyarados, and then he gets 5 hits with Greninja on a Kartana and almost reverse sweeps him with Greninja. How much percent was the Magina at? What percentage was the Magina at? Oh, also the turn where he went for Groundium, I think he should have gone for Magma Storm there. But I do understand that he probably predicted the Zygarde and he didn't want to risk missing a Magma Storm. It was at 14%, so I don't think it was a roll. Never mind then. I mean, it was maybe a roll, but it was heavily in Poik's favor, so that. Damn, that's crazy. So he would have won the game, most likely. 13.6. I'm pretty sure the Magina would have been in range then, because. It might not have been at 14%, it might have been at 13%, knowing how Shodan works. Thank you guys for watching Wild Game. Let me look at the score real quick. Flaming. Victini does take the game for the. Indie Scooters, as the score is now 5-4. Oh, actually, don't. There's a game that I haven't uploaded yet, but it's fine. I'm pretty sure most of you guys will know the result anyway. But yeah, I will upload that the next days. And yeah, let me see, what else was I gonna say? Yeah, I was just gonna rewatch this turn real quick where he got the 5 shuriken hits. I think, I mean, you guys can see that the crit at 22 and the other hits do 16. And the last did 12, so it probably, if it would have done 16, I think it would have been a roll to kill, but don't quote me on that. But yeah, this was a wild game, good gravy. Good lord, I don't even know what to say. But yeah, I have a freaking headache. I hope you guys all enjoyed. And yeah, I also recorded TDK's game earlier. What else did I record? I recorded like a few lower tier games that I'm gonna pass to my man Ultra Balls. And yeah, just like I said, the games that I wasn't able to catch narrate live today. If I'm not able to do them tomorrow either, then they're gonna be coming over the next week. Goodbye, friends.